sports. It's in the game.
Chase McLaughlin has it on the tee, and off we go here in Tampa. And he opts to not bring this one out. The first drive will start at the 25. Philly's offense getting ready, and Jalen Hurts ready to lead them. The second-round pick who started his career at Alabama, then finished with an electric senior season at Oklahoma.
Tremendous production in college at two different universities, and this is a guy who was a finalist for a Heisman Trophy. Still much more of a runner than a thrower, but has plenty of arm and is capable of making the big throws downfield. And don't underestimate his ability to think the game. Remember, he's the son of a coach.
That's quite a way to start this football game on the ground right away. They're almost near midfield.
And that run, whether you're for this team or against them, it brings you out of your seat, doesn't it? Because that's an exciting way to get things rolling. Now you've got to hunker down on defense. Another first down run.
Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and nine. They'll stay on the ground with Swift. And a nice run. They're going to take this close to the first down marker at the Bucs 39. And hold on here, because on that last run, it looks like we have a player who was shaken up. Well, now they're going to come out and take a look at this injury. Try and run here with Swift. And he's going to have the first down at about the 38. You were telling me this yesterday. That's exactly what they want to do on the opening drive, establish the ground game.
Yeah, remember our conversation. We were talking about what one of the GMs in the league has told me repeatedly. It's a big man's game, and it's not necessarily size. He's talking about playing some big boy football. Line up, get leverage, knock people back, and establish the run early.
2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
This drive is pretty clear. Almost feels like old school fundamentals, doesn't it? Want to impose their will on the defense. What's that, five straight runs?
Yeah, five straight carries to start this drive, and like you said, the way it's working, they may just stick with it. On second down, Swift. Give him three on the run there. Now they're looking at a third and about five. Just not a whole lot of room to operate on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job standing in proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
Play number seven now coming up on the drive. Third and five. They will run straight ahead with Swift. And he's going to get this down near the 20-yard line. All runs on this drive so far. It's first and 10. Start of the second quarter, and it's the Eagles in possession as they've got it with a first and 10. Swift going to try up the middle. And he'll take this inside the 20 and down to the 18. A short gain of just over 2 yards as the first half clock dips inside of 3 minutes.
He's had success on this drive, but not on this play.
Finally, they bowed up defensively. I think they were determined not to let him take it pretty much all the way down the field.
Yeah, it looks like they handled their run responsibilities correctly this time. What we call them, run fits, everyone was in the right place.
On second down, Gainwell looking for space. And he'll take it from the 18 to the 15, a gain of 3. This offense has converted 2 third downs on this drive already. This is 3rd and 4. On the ground with a tight end. And oh, he's just going to be short here, barely. Maybe by a half a foot. It'll be 4th and inches. And hold on here, because on that last run, it looks like we have a player who was shaken up. Well, hopefully, obviously, nothing serious here. Medical staff, though, going to take a peek, and we'll take a break. Giving to the big tight end on 4th. But he's able to pick up the first down before he's tackled right at the 10. They only needed a few inches, and they didn't get much more than that. But by about the width of a shoelace, they convert on 4th down. They'll run here with Gainwell. And from the 9, they get this to the 5-yard line.
When you look at the geography we're staring at, this part of the field, don't you always think of big backs carrying the football, bruisers trying to pound it in? Instead, we look at a little more of a scat back type, and he's trying to make it happen.
Yeah, they went with the elusive, slippery guy, couldn't get it. And he's in for an Eagles touchdown. Kenneth Gainwell, a 5-yard touchdown run. And the Eagles post the first points of the ball game as they take the lead here in this second quarter. Elliott good on the extra point, and it's now a 7-0 game. So that drive spans 13 plays. And it was Kenneth Gainwell who finished it off with a touchdown run. And this will be a touchback, so they'll bring it out to the 25. So out come the Bucs now for their first drive. Under center, it's the 2017 Heisman Trophy winner as you get a look at Baker Mayfield.
And his task in this situation is making sure that his team knows that there's a sense of urgency, yet somehow still stays calm. Because your natural impulse, your first possession is not until the second quarter, is you got to attack right away. Throw something big at them right away. Yeah, you got to move the ball. But...
And this intercepted on the first play of the game. Picked off by the corner, Bradley Roby. Well, when I looked down, he was kind of shaking his head right after he threw that pass. What did you see?
Well, from a defense's perspective, anytime you have your eyes back towards the quarterback, you're in a position to make a play on the ball, whether it's a big-time play by you or an overthrow by the quarterback. You have a much better opportunity.
Give him five on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
Offensive linemen love creating space for their guys carrying the ball, but when that guy also breaks tackles and creates extra yardage, they almost feel like he's one of them, and they really embrace him.
And they'll fake it there on the jet sweep, and instead, here's Swift. The Eagles going to take the first of their timeouts as they stop it here with just under 40 ticks to go in this first half. A couple extra tight ends in the formation here as they line up third and two. And they'll try and run for it with Gainwell. And they'll get this down to the 10. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
First and goal, Philadelphia.
And they'll stay on the ground with Gainwell again. And he's going to ball his way down to about the 1 yard line. Now the Eagles will use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop the clock with 12 seconds to go in this first half. Gainwell is into the end zone for an Eagle touchdown. So his strong first half continues as he finds the end zone here for the second time.
And definitely good blocking at the point of attack, and you just have to love watching the way he can create space down near the goal line, and he's able to take it into the end zone.
Elliott good with a PAT, and it's now 14-0. So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. Right after the touchdown to extend their lead, now maybe opening the door a little bit there by allowing starting field position at the 40. Well, you don't see that often. He just mishit it, and it goes out of bounds.
Well, I know sitting up here, and I'm looking at you, and you're looking at me, and I know we're both thinking the same thing. Isn't it easy enough to keep it between the sidelines? Because unless you're intentionally doing it for some reason, but that's a costly mishit, and now you put your team in a bad spot.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete.
And a smart play there. He's probably saying, I wish I would have done that on the last drive instead of throwing the interception.
Now Mayfield. The pass is caught by Cade Otton. And with just 1 second remaining in the first half, they'll call the timeout. Final play of the half, Mayfield. He's going to throw one up for the end zone. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete. So we've reached halftime here, and it's our visitors, the Eagles, leading this one. As we send you a stone's throw away across I-4 to Orlando, there standing by is Jonathan Coachman, ready with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach?
The highlights are fairly one-sided to this point. It's a two-touchdown difference here at the break, but I wouldn't call this one over just yet. I think there could still be some fireworks yet to come. Second half straight ahead from Raymond James Stadium. Both teams finishing up their halftime adjustments. So for the call, let's get back over to Tampa and rejoin Brandon and Charles.
And this will not be returned, so the second half begins with a touchback. Out come the Buccaneers. They'll have it first to start the third quarter. Charles, it'll be interesting to see what adjustments this offense made in the haven't really been able to get anything going offensively, virtually nothing in the ground attack either. So certainly something has to change here in quarter three.
their friends from the defensive side of the ball told them exactly that, because those guys, the stop troops, they've been playing pretty well. They've kept them around in this game. Now, they've got some time. The running game struggled in the first half. Opposition knows how to focus on defending the pass here. They've got to re-energize that ground game and maybe open things up for a comeback here in this half.
A first down throw from Mayfield. And his throw is incomplete.
I'm getting the sense that this offense is getting frustrated. Here we are into the third quarter, and they've had plenty of opportunities to get in sync. Thus far, that hasn't happened. They're looking for answers, both on the sideline and in the huddle looking at each other.
And he'll only get a yard, maybe two, up to the 46.
Well, they still have time to get him established, but in my estimation, they've got to pick up the urgency here. They've got to get quickly in and out of the huddle and run off a bunch more plays.
On third down, Mayfield. He had a man open, but he missed him, and it's incomplete.
Well, if they have any designs of getting back into this football game in the second half, they're going to need to be much sharper offensively than they were on this opening possession. Not much happening here, and it'll lead to a fourth down.
And on fourth down, on is the punt team sending this one away. And no one there to stop it. Hits at the 8, but it carries all the way into the end zone for a touchback. So here are the Eagles now as they get set for their first possession of the second half. This is sort of what you would call a put-away drive, isn't it? I mean, they score here, especially a touchdown. It's almost out of reach.
It certainly feels that way, and I think that they're going to call their plays accordingly, because what you really want to do, even though you know the scoreboard is still up there and the game's going to go on, in fact, you can take the spirit away from another team, that their drive and will to come back and win can be taken with another score right here.
Still third quarter, but you just get that feel.
Yeah, they're teetering right there on the brink, aren't they?
And this winds up a pickup of two, maybe two and a half, to about the 39.
Oh, that's a real nice job there by the defensive front. They just engaged and held their ground. But how about the guy who made the play? We often talk about whether they take a good first step or not. Many times you just don't take any step. Just get your feet moving, get your body going. And then once he made the read, he was able to make the play.
Looking to speed things up here, going with some tempo. On third down, here comes Swift. Boy, no chance as he was met and dropped behind the line there. Tough sledding. They lose a yard there on third.
Sometimes you just sit back and marvel at what he can do defensively. Speed, strength, quickness. He's the whole package. And that package just wrapped up the runner for a loss.
Is going to do it for this third quarter of action. Back now in Tampa as we are set to bring you the home stretch here, the fourth quarter. The Eagles send out their punter now. Always a good sign when your first punt comes in the fourth quarter. 42-yard punt, 6 on the return, and the Bucs will get ready to go on offense. And Tampa Bay trots out there now. And you're still in this game. I mean, yeah, you haven't scored. Offense obviously has struggled, but you're only two scores down, so all hope not lost.
Not at all, because we were talking about the NFL, and teams can score fast in this league. Quick strikes, you're right back in it. You're exactly right. Keeping hope alive. And the off.
To the line. To throw, Mayfield. This ball complete to Trey Palmer. All three timeouts plus the two-minute warning. Here's first and 10. Mayfield. He'll dump this one off here to White. And give him 6 yards here as he stopped near the 35 at the 34. 2 minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. So it's Buccaneer football as we welcome you back. Now second and 4. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. Now this throw caught left side. And he'll be tackled right on the chalk of the 45. Mayfield to throw. Finds White.
You got the big lead defensively. You're willing to give him that underneath stuff, right?
And this is why you work on your tackling. Tackle him after the catch, inbounds, keep the clock running. Just go ahead and bleed the game out that way.
Throwing again on second down, but this time it's incomplete.
Give him big credit for his coverage right there, because when he saw the route break deep, he stayed in position to prevent a completion while avoiding any risk of a flag.
Mayfield. He's going to have the hook up to Gage. And he is going to have the Buccaneers first down, although it doesn't appear to be by much. He needed four, and he got four on third down. Meanwhile, Mayfield's throw taken in by Evans here. And this winds up a gain of four to the 41. Now the Bucs going to use the first of their timeouts as the clock stops here with 46 seconds left to play. Mayfield. That is caught. It's Chris Godwin. The Bucs going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. Now Mayfield. Looking for Godwin again, and he's got him once more. The Bucs forced to use their third and final timeout. And is it?
Over on their respective sidelines, we take a break.
Here's Baker. And his throw here is incomplete.
A lot of practice time, a lot of thinking goes into two-minute drills, even on the defensive side. So now you want to make sure the guys understand. Continue to be aggressive, but make sure you're smart in doing so.
Mayfield with it once more. Work in the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete. And he is going to have a Bucs first down. Plenty able to get 8 yards there on third and two. And he will throw this one out of the back of the end zone. It's incomplete.
And now defensively in the two-minute drill, the big key to me, make sure you understand your assignments, and anytime you get a chance to tackle someone in bounds, get them on the ground.
Now a second down throw for the end zone, but it's incomplete.
Give them credit for excellent coverage, tight coverage. They're doing a lot of things that we talk about in basketball. They're causing disruptions in the passing game. And as long as that continues, it'll be tough for them to gain any momentum throwing the ball down.
And he's going to go down, sacked right around the 17. So fly, Eagles, fly. It's a victory for Philadelphia, and they did it in shutout fashion. Impressive.
Would it be too bland of a statement to say they didn't have the greatest day offensively? I mean,
did enough, but yeah, you're right.
Most games, it wouldn't have been enough. So they've got to go into the locker room and applaud their defensive mates and say, guys, you really carried us today. We'll try and get you back next time. But as for today, you guys were nails out there.